Middle school students are incredibly optimistic, and anytime they walk in your classroom, they just feel like the possibilities are endless and that you're on a great adventure with them throughout the course of the year. So I love teaching middle schoolers because they're so optimistic and fun to be around and full of energy. So far, we've been to Raccoon Mountain and Moxon Bend Archaeological District and also West Chickamauga Creek. The remaining trips of the year include Ross's Landing, the Chattanooga Choo Choo, Point Park, Forest Hills Cemetery, Missionary Ridge, and then we'll end the year with Coolidge Park.
When you walk into this classroom, you never expect for it to just be a boring lesson. It's always different and unique and something that you have like learned or like you've developed something new, and it's a cool experience because he's just so passionate about it.
We're within, you know, 5 miles of most of the places we're talking about. To be able to go to such historic places and get there quickly and to actually do the lesson on site, I think is, for me, much more powerful and beneficial than just doing the lesson in the classroom when we can actually go just outside and do it.
It makes history a lot more real to be able to stand there on the Trail of Tears, to understand the gravity of the situation, to not learn it out of a textbook, but to learn it from the ground you're standing on. And your amazing history teacher who's standing there with you. And it really just feels like you were there, and you were there on Raccoon Mountain. And it's just such a crazy, amazing experience to be able to be in history.
Yeah, seeing what happened and how long the journey was and just a little short portion of it can just give you a huge perspective on how they went through it, what they had to do to get through it. Like, it just gives you a visual experience about it.
One of the tools we can use in the history classroom is empathy, where you're really trying to get in the mindset of what that person was thinking and why they made that decision. And the past is difficult to navigate when you're dealing with different cultures and circumstances. It's often far more complicated than we like to make it. I think that storytelling is really an underrated part of history curriculum, you know, and I think human beings have told stories for thousands of years, and that has really been one of the primary ways that we learn is through storytelling. When you can go to a place and tell a story and do it well, you know, I think kids are using their imagination, they're trying to imagine what it would have looked like or imagining the characters in their actual setting. There's something really powerful about that, of being in the same space as these historic people or events, and literally the only thing separating you is time. And that's always something that I've taken, just that idea of being able to go and tell a powerful story in a beautiful place, and for kids to use their imagination and be able to try and envision what that would have been like. I'm Clay Huffaker, and I teach 8th grade U.S. History.